also very interesting word and sometimes abused as well. it can mean differently and contextually to different people. For me, operational excellence is skill of the bottommost individual working in the chemical industry. That makes huge difference, because if my operator who is actually working on the flow, take the case of a technician, take the case of a rigger who is actually doing a material lifting of huge tonnage quantity to the second, third, fourth floor buildings, his ability to properly anchor, or a welding technician properly welding, these are all very special processes in chemical industries. Special processes are those processes whose quality cannot be tested before usage. You can only see when you actually use it. At the most, we can do the radiography. For me, the operator training, operator development, operator skill is the first basic building block. And the next challenge for us in chemical industries, while we have number of chemical engineers and other engineers coming out of universities and coming, the real talent required is becoming a challenge. And these people who are at the operators and technicians, how will we really? They are very good in doing, but they're not very good in telling or transferring the skills to others. A huge challenge for chemical processing industry is today is one way, the one side is to get automated AI, augmented reality, all these things that we are talking about, but then the basics have to be brilliant. When I focus on these operators, how I can convert that implicit knowledge to explicit level, it's like, it's an example comes from home. Mothers, they make good, delicious food. If you ask them to try, they will not even use the spoon. They will use just some fingers and put it. And it's so tasty and delicious. So it is something like that. Implicit to explicit is a challenge. Operational excellence is where you can convert that to this. Third is definitely to be more competitive. We have no option than to get processes automated. We have to go for other, Nowadays, orders are coming through mobile. Our products. So that is definitely has to be a medium to long-term strategy. When we combine all these four or five things, definitely operational excellence, it's again an integrated, aspect than one simple thing. If you can have my basic skills right for my people who are working, ability to translate implicit knowledge to explicit knowledge, and then I automate wherever it is practically and economically viable scenarios without becoming absolute before it is absoluting us. That's the challenge. Why it is important for operational excellence? Definitely plants have to be life of the plant, upgradations from time to time. And one other interesting thing I always spoke to my finance guy is that you take depreciation every year 10%, are you putting back that into the replacement of equipment or refurbishment? So there has to be some integration of depreciation also in economic depreciation, that we need to really move forward that way, integrating financial strategy to the operation strategy. Then I would say it is operational excellence. It's not in isolation and standalone situation. For me, the first performance indicator is my responsiveness as management to the working team. The working team always has to be available, the management team has to be available to the work team immediate responsiveness of the management. It's of course a behavior management, but still the ability to management to respond to the situation, especially in COVID times, we could see that. So the ability of the management to respond very quickly, very swiftly is one first indicator I would see, because everything happens from top down. The second one is in chemical industries, any chemical industry has a life of 25 years, 35 years. It can have an infinite life provided we continually, periodically, in a scheduled manner, in a structured manner, refurbish the equipment. So how timely, correctly we are either refurbishing the equipments and the upgrading the technology. See, suppose if I take the life of a plant for 10 years, I may be getting the numbers because of market situation, but I really don't know the condition of what's happening to them. Sometimes, you know, there is a tendency to upgrade the technology for the key equipments, but not upstream and downstream. That's a huge challenge. Like warehouses, like supply chain management. If I give this last 20 years, the quantity or the that we transport to trucks has increased from 15 tons to 40 tons trailers, Tuskers. Have we really enhanced those facilities of supply and management logistics in our plants? Which were not done, that would put a lot of inherent safety risks we create there. So these three things to me are very critical: management responsiveness and timely refurbishment upgradation of equipments. And these are very, very top level. At the middle level, it has to be the enhancement of the robustness of the processes. You know, the tendency is to get the results quickly, and everybody is fancied about looking at the numbers. But to get to the numbers, you know, in safety, we call it leading indicators and lagging indicators. You know, lagging indicator is, there were two incidents. So the leading indicators are the shop floor people are talking to each other and working. We call them safety action meetings. They are supposed to conduct safety action meetings every week. Are they conducting? Suddenly we see that last 3 months it is missing. So we focus on leading indicators. They are actually predictors for the results. And actually identifying the good leading indicators, developing good relations of leading indicators to the lagging indicators, in the research language we call predictors, and then monitoring them. We can't just see the numbers. So this is at the middle level. At the bottom level, the key is the engagement of workforce.